Yubi Jubi! Now isn't that a wonderful sight? The six Federation vessels, Enterprise, all lined up in a row. All majestic and beautiful. And yes, I said Federation Starship Enterprises, not Starfleet Enterprises, because the NX-01 is a Starfleet Enterprise, but it is not a Federation Enterprise, since it predated the Federation. You see? See, get around little loopholes like that. Also, there isn't a Micro Machines NX-01. Someone on eBay is selling some dodgy little fake version of the NX-01, which I may pick up at some point just to add it to this little group. But it's not an official one, so I'm not counting it in the complete set that I have here. Now, this isn't going to be in-depth about every tiny little detail and how accurate every tiny little thing is, because, quite frankly, I don't know how accurate they are to the exact on-screen duplicates. I'm just going to talk about them just quickly, one at a time, just being nice and friendly. Now, personally, I prefer these stands to be facing the other way, so that that way around, but the ship's pointing towards the camera, and they can do that, except for the D, which is a bit front heavy, which is unfortunate, but oh well. Anyway, I mean, the standard stands, easy enough to do, but what we're really interested in is the actual ship itself. Hey, I finally got the bugger to focus. So here we are. The first Enterprise we ever saw, Kirk's little ship, and it's a really nice little representation. It doesn't have a lot of detailing and panel lines, but as far as I am aware, the original model didn't either. It does have little windows scribed in, and it's got a little bit of paint marking along the hull and on the nacelles there. It's got a nice little stubby deflector dish. I mean, overall, it's a nice little ship. This one I managed to get straight out of a pack, so the nacelles aren't bent, because it's painful when you have a bent nacelle. But overall, the colour seems to match up nicely. There's no glaring obvious differences. It does have some panel lining on the top of the hull. There you go, you can see it there. And I really like the registration on this ship. It's a very small font, but very tidy. Very nice ship. Now, unfortunately, mine does have a bit of a defect here, just below the nacelle. It's got a big dent in it, like some Romulan ship rammed into them and buckled the hull a bit. I don't like that. See, that's why I'm not getting any more Micro Machine ships now I've got the set. I mean, on this side, it's fine. It's the full, proper cylindrical shape, but detail-wise, it's a bit bare on details, but let's face it, the original studio model didn't exactly have loads of nitpicky little details on it, but, you know, for a little representation of the original Enterprise, it's fairly decent. You've got your little phaser bank knobbles sticking out everywhere. You can't see them, but there's some silver paint on the shuttle bay at the back. Overall, perfect? Probably not. But it's a good little representation. I like that. I like that one. Now we come to this one. The Enterprise A. Now, the refit Constitution is my favorite ship design of all the Star Trek ships. I can't put my finger on it, but there's just something about the way this ship looks that I just absolutely love to bits. And already you can see my problem with this. Yeah. His nacelle's bent. I hate bent nacelles! Now this came in a box set. You could only get the A through the first box set that was released. So yeah, unless you can find that box set, mint and sealed box, you're gonna have to get this through the post. And that means you're gonna get bent nacelles. And the amount of bending on that nacelle is... it's just criminal. I mean, look at it! Oh, look at it! It's pathetic! I am actually tempted to get another one of these and then see if I can remove the A and call one of these the refit Enterprise from the first three films. Which reminds me of something else I want to talk about later on. Bent nacelles. It's the curse of the Star Trek ship collector. Now, ignoring the bent nacelle problem, it is actually a really nice ship. It's a sort of... well, I don't know what colour it is. It's not white, but it's not grey. It's sort of a greyish-bluish tint to it. But there's lots of detailing on the top of the hull, similar to what that one had. You see? They are similar. Which is nice. It's nice. But this one also has panel lining underneath, which gives it a lot more detail. I mean, it's still got the little painted hull markings on here, the Federation stripe. A painted deflector dish this time, because that's what the A had, as opposed to the actual satellite dish. I mean, overall, it's a nice ship. If it wasn't for the bent nacelle, I would be in love with this little thing. There's no silver on the shuttle bay like the last one. Now, here we are. This is another reason why I'm not getting any more Micro Machine ships. Look at the paint on that nacelle. I mean, what the hell happened to that? You see? Can you see? It should run along there, where my nail is. My nail that needs cutting. It should run along there. You know, like... well, yeah, along the glowy part of the nacelle. But no, it runs down here, down to the bottom, and disappears off down the bottom. And it's like, what the hell is that meant to be? It's pathetic. No care and attention to that whatsoever. You know, I may actually get another one of these. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. But, I mean, other than those two things, if this was straight out of the box and that paint was done properly, this would be a damn fine ship. It really would. A beautiful representation of the A. But, I'm sorry, that just lets it down. It really does. And it's a shame because, like I say, this is my favourite version of the Enterprise. Oh well. I'll just have to get a Johnny Lightning version of the refit as well. Oh dear. Now we come to the B. The infamous Enterprise. The one that got Captain Kirk killed on its maiden voyage. Honestly? It's a good ship. Now this one I got out of its packet as well myself. So once again, the nacelles nice and straight, near enough. Certainly not noticeable. Now this one has a lot of panel lines and small fiddly details on it. I don't know how accurate those details are to the screen, but it gives the ship a... someone just flew it into the Nexus. It is a really nice ship. You know, the silhouette, the design of it looks just like it does on screen. And I really like that. Again, the Enterprise writing text is really small, but really well done. So yeah, there you are, the Enterprise B, Excelsior class. I wish there was more stories done with this. I would love to see the voyages of the Enterprise B and Captain Harriman. But alas, that was relegated to books. So apparently she had quite a distinguished career, but well, there you go. Now we come to the Enterprise C, an ambassador class ship that was only seen on the wall of the Enterprise D and was only seen in person in one episode of The Next Generation, yesterday's Enterprise. You mention its episode and it has stage fright. The Enterprise C, Ambassador Class. Captain Rachel Garrett was the commanding officer. You know what? This was also one I got off eBay. Now this one has an insane amount of Aztec-ing on it. I mean, yeah, there you go, you can see that. Look at that, it's just absolutely insane. And I like that. I like that a lot. Now the colours of this ship are a bit off. Now I'm colourblind and even I can tell the colours of this ship is a bit off. But, you know, it doesn't detract from the overall ship itself. I mean, the deflector dish sticks out quite a bit. You see? I mean, it's like, woo! What is going on there? That deflector dish needs a trim. Just like my nails do. But overall, the Enterprise C, it's a good little ship, it's a sturdy little ship, and it's a tough little ship. Look at those nacelles. Not a bend on them. That's what I like to see. Oh yes. That's why the Enterprise C was able to give those Romulans a run for their money when they were defending the Klingon base. It's because this ship was built to last. Absolutely beautiful. The Enterprise C needs more love as well. Now we come to the second most famous Enterprise. The Enterprise D. Let's see if this one can fall off its stand. The Enterprise D. Galaxy class, Captain Jean-Luc Picard. Now this one is the version that separates the saucer section. There were two of these, one that could separate and one that couldn't. I did have the one that couldn't separate. It's currently at my parents' house and I kind of cut it along the hull so it could separate. But that's before, this was years ago, before I even knew you could get one that could separate, so yeah. But this one is the one that can separate, and this one has a lot more Aztec-ing and panel lines molded into it. And you can see there, that is just like the C. I mean, look, the C and the D together, you can see both of them have insane amount of panel lines just welded in, and it gives the ship that sense of scale, because these are humongous ships we're getting into now. Crews of 1,000 easy, probably more. But you know, this one I got through eBay, and guess what? the nacelles are straight! Hooray! I do like it when the nacelles are straight. Now this Enterprise has a very, very tiny registration plate on the saucer. I mean, It's right there and you can barely read it. It's that small. But that's just because the D is such a big ship. But overall, it is a really nice representation of the D. There's no... I can't see any paint going crazy places like there was on the A. I mean, it's just... it's just absolutely beautiful. And of course, because it's the one that can separate, I have to do this. There we go. Now, it's a simple peg into post hole. Yeah, okay. So the saucer is flying around with a big post sticking out the back. But there's no other way they can do this. And you know what? It's fine. It is absolutely fine. There's... You can't put the saucer on a stand, unfortunately. Because that would have been pretty cool if there was a... Just a little... Just a little hole in there beside the post so you could just go... And just have the saucer flying about like that. Because you can still have the battle section... Engineering section, like that. Would have been nice. It's not needed, but would have been nice. But what they have done is put the panel lines and Aztec-ing on this section here as well, where the battle bridge would be. Which means, when it's separated, you don't just get a big blank splodge. You can still display it like this, and it... You can display it like this, and it looks fine. It really does look fine. Well, they didn't do that on here. It's just a big blank spot, but... I can forgive them that. I can forgive them that for having an Enterprise D that separates. And then we get to my second favourite ship, which is going to fall off as I pick it up. My second favourite Enterprise, the E. Now, this was only available in a very short run based on... What was it? It was a box set, the final third box set, which the run was also coming to an end on. So these E's are in extremely limited numbers, and if you go on eBay, you can't see that they normally go for 40 quid, and let me tell you something, this is not worth 40 quid. Fortunately, I managed to get one for cheap. Well, I say cheap, it was a lot cheaper than 40 quid, put it that way. And you know what, it's the kind of thing you appreciate as a collector's piece. You can collect the collector value to it, but as an actual representation of the Enterprise E, it is severely lacking. I mean, for a start, it's the wrong colour. This area along the hull here should be darker. There's no Aztec-ing whatsoever. There's only one row of windows around the outside. The phaser strips aren't highlighted in. The deflector dish isn't coloured in. If you notice on these ones, deflector dish is coloured. Deflector dish is coloured. Deflector dish. Okay, so it's a big black blob, but there's nothing else around there that's black, so, you know, you could call that coloured. Deflector dish coloured. Deflector dish coloured. It's like they couldn't be bothered with this one. They got to the E and they knew they were wrapping up, they just couldn't be bothered, so they just said, here, do that, and be done with it. I mean, there is barely any colour at all on the underside of the ship. It's ridiculous. And yes, bent nacelle. Grrr. Now, what little paint is on this thing? It's not sloppy. It's all where it's meant to be, except for a tiny little bit on the ram scoops. But generally, it's fine. It's just not enough. I mean, this is the newest Enterprise in terms of the timeline. It's the ship that... It's the flagship of the fleet. It's the one that's in the movies. And they just phone it in. They just... If I'd have paid 40 quid for this, I would be severely disappointed. In fact, I honestly am... a little disappointed with what I paid for it to begin with, but you know, collector mentality, it's something you get to have, if you know what I mean. You get it for the collector sake, not to have a representation of the E. There are much better ones out there, like the Furuta or the Konomi. Personally, I'm going to get the Konomi Enterprise E as well, because that thing looks sweet! But I had to complete the Enterprise set, so I had to get this piece. Honestly, yeah, very disappointed with it. And my ships have all fallen over. I think I've rambled long enough now about these things. Well, at the end of the day, what can I say? Well, if you like little representations of your Star Trek ships, yeah, if you can find them cheap, I would not pay more than a fiver for any of these, and I would be very wary that a lot of them, like these ones with the long nacelles, Excelsior classes, Galaxy classes, Ambassador classes, Miranda classes, things like that with short stubby nacelles, they should be alright. But things with the long swept nacelles, like the Sovereigns and the Constitutions, be extremely wary of those, as they will most likely have warped nacelles. I would not pay a lot per ship, but they're a fun, novel little thing to have if you want a little collection of Star Trek ships floating about. I mean, yeah, most of them do have good details on them. The paint can be a little sloppy sometimes, but generally the paint is fine on them. But like you saw with the A, you do get the odd time where it's just, what were you thinking? And I would certainly avoid the Enterprise E unless you need to have it to complete the set. That's the only time I could recommend it. But do not pay 40 quid for it. Just, no matter how rare it is not worth that. Considering how much paint is missing from it, how inaccurate the thing is. No. But, ultimately, there you have it. A wonderful little Enterprise collection. Micro Machines finally complete.